Hey friends, just a quick vlog here to introduce my new Triumph Speed 400. So this is the bike. It's in the black color and it's a stock motorcycle with a lot of add-ons, which we are going to talk about in a moment from now. So motorcycle is done about 5,000 odd kilometers at this point in time, and bike is performing flawlessly, and it's a pleasure to ride this bike, both be it the city or be it on the highway. So it doesn't disappoint you in either of the places. So this video especially is a sort of an introductory video and not a in-depth review. So I'm going to take you around and show you. You can see it's at about 5,381. Bike is totally settled. Yes, the radiator fan comes on when you are in traffic, stop and go traffic, but it doesn't really bother as much. So all you need to make sure is there is sufficient coolant and all of that. So coming back to the motorcycle. So what's on this motorcycle extra from which doesn't come from the showroom as a stock bike, right? So to start off, right, so I got these tank pads and this knee pads and the tank pad from Triumph, and that is one. It's a very good add-on because when you sit on the motorcycle with your riding gear or a jacket, the zipper tends to, you know, scrape this part of the tank. If you don't have this, your tank is certain to get some scratch marks, right? So that is one. And this one is super useful so that you can grip your knees here and not slide down in case of, you know, fast riding or so under harsh braking condition, etc. So very useful stuff. Apart from that, there is a 3M PPF on the fuel tank. It's completely protected with PPF, so that's taken care. And along with that, yes, these are the stock crash guards. They're not very wide, but sufficient enough to, you know, be sleek enough and protect the motorcycle in case of a fall. But I'm not sure if it is going to protect the rider knees as much as the bigger ones might have, but I didn't really want to go for anything aftermarket, so I just stuck on to the stock Triumph stuff. And another add-on was this lower sump guard, right? You see this lower crash guard? So this is the one which is going to protect your radiator tank, what is here, right? Radiator tank already has a cover which has a metal plate below that, so it's a double protection. So this is going to protect that, and in case of a fall, right, your engine cases are also protected with this. So that was one add-on, and it comes on both the sides to protect your engine casing and the sump, and also a radiator to an extent here in case of an impact, right? That was one. And the next one is the fork covers, the fork seal covers, and this was from Motor Trends. So basically all it does is prevents the dust particles to enter from here and get into the seal and break the seal. So it's going to, you know, enhance and typically enhance the longevity of your fork seal. So that was one. Then another kit what Triumph had was rain protection kit, something of that sort, which had this extended part which was added onto this, and I think this mud flap here. And the stock one comes till here actually, so the rain protection kit had this longer one also, so this was installed. And Along with that, this particular piece was installed as part of the rain protection kit. And additionally, I have got the tire hugger to, you know, address the water, rainwater splashing onto the rider or the pillion, especially when you are riding it in the rain. So this is going to take care of about 80% of that stuff and avoid the rainwater coming onto the rider or pillion, for that example, for that matter. So that was one. And next thing I added was the Carbon Racing side stand extender. Super useful if you are going to park your bike on any kind of soft terrain or mud, etc. So it's not going to sink in, it's going to have a very solid grip. That was one. And yeah, so I've got this top rack installed from Triumph again. So it comes with this aluminium plate, as you can see here below. And what you see here, this plate is from GV top box. It's a monolock top box, which is about 32 liter in capacity, and can store your basic stuff, one full face helmet, riding gear, etc., etc. So all of those things, so can do that. Next, I've added this quilted seat from Time, right? So the stock seat, the problem is, right, stock seat, it gets a bit uncomfortable with when you are especially riding for extended kilometers or hours, right? It gets very uncomfortable. So I went ahead and upgraded my seat to a quilted seat. So yeah, so liking it so far. It's amazing, actually. And next, what have I done? All right, so next is, of course, there is a, you see the sticker there? So that signifies that the bike is running on a DNA performance air filter. Yes, there is a difference, my friend. There is a difference. You just don't pay 6,000 rupees for an air filter just like that. So not only does it provide higher level of filtration, it also gives about 10 to 15% of more air into the engine to ensure better combustion and firing. So yeah, so immediate difference after installing this DNA I found was the amount of soot what used to get collected here has drastically reduced. So it goes to say that I'm having a cleaner combustion, I'm having a complete combustion of air and fuel mixture. So that is happening. Finally, yes, I have my quad lock here for the mobile mount. Then I got these offset handlebar risers from Carbon Racing, right? So what this does is it actually moves the handlebar a bit behind and also a bit taller. So in terms of your riding stance, your riding stance becomes a bit more relaxed. So a bit more relaxed, not like, you know, not, it doesn't become an Avenger or whatever, but slightly bit more relaxed than more committed. So yeah, that's helping in longer rides, especially because you don't have to lean in on the handlebar and the weight indirectly comes onto your wrists and palms. So that has stopped. So it pretty much addressed what it was supposed to do. So it's doing that. And next, I think, yeah, that's about it in terms of add-ons on the motorcycle. And I believe I have a complete motorcycle with all the accessories at this point in time. Yeah, just not to forget about the radiator guard, which is here. So there's a radiator guard here, again from Triumph. So as much as possible, I've tried to stick on to the OEM accessories from Triumph, because I always believe, I've tried everything in life on different bikes, different third-party accessories, etc., but finally concluded that manufacturer always knows the best for the motorcycle what they have designed. So going by that approach, I just went ahead and got this. Oh yeah, another one was adjustable levers, right? So this motorcycle comes with standard levers which are not adjustable, right? So I got these adjustable levers. Yes, these are from 390 Adventure standard model. So I got this from the KTM showroom and I have installed. It's a plug and play, it's a direct fit, and that's pretty much the advantage because both the bikes are essentially manufactured in Bajaj's Chakan plant. So there's a lot of part sharing going on there, so let's take benefit out of it. So just did that. Yeah, so that is the motorcycle, my friends. Those are the add-ons, right? Yes, I'll be doing an in-depth review of the motorcycle very soon. So at this point in time, I just want to this to be an introduction to Speed 400 and the accessories what I've added on. So yeah, thank you for tuning in and watching this video. Do let me know your thoughts in the comment section. As always, love to interact with you guys, and take care and have a wonderful rest of the day. Thank you.